Here's a quick Blender tutorial on camera depth of field, also referred to as background blur. Depth of field is the concept of the camera being in focus at a certain distance. What is behind or in front of that distance will be out of focus and blurry. Just how blurry the effect is can be adjusted. Blender can create this effect in both Eevee and Cycles. Here's how. To create depth of field, we need a camera in our scene. This scene I have set up is a monkey, obviously, a plane with a bunch of grass on it, a single tree in the background, and an HDRI. The grass I created with a single click using Scatter, which is pretty much my favorite Blender add-on ever. I've got a video all about it. And the HDRI I simply dropped in from my HDRI library, which I have a video on how to set up for free. I set up the camera so that some blades of grass will be right in front of it. The tree will be in the distant background, and the camera will primarily be focused on the Suzanne monkey. With the camera selected, we go to the Camera Properties panel. Click the camera icon right here to get there. I'm in Cycles, by the way, but this works in Eevee the exact same way. Find the area labeled Depth of Field. Check it on and open up the options. Depth of Field gives the camera a distance to focus at. We can manually choose how far away the camera should be focused, but that will probably take a lot of trial and error. The easier option, if we have a specific object or character we are trying to focus on, is to use the Focus Object option. We can choose the object we want to focus on from the drop-down box, or we can use the eyedropper tool to select the object. Let's select the Suzanne. Notice nothing is visible in object mode. The depth of field will only display in material preview mode, render preview mode, and of course in the final render. This is what we get by default. The grass is a little blurry in the foreground, and the tree and HDRI are a little blurry in the background. To adjust the strength of the depth of field, we are going to go down to the aperture settings and change the f-stop. An f-stop is a measurement of the opening of the aperture in a real camera, and Blender simulates the operation of a real camera surprisingly well. Lowering the f-stop value will increase the blurriness of the depth of field. Increasing the f-stop value will decrease the intensity of the blur. The rest of these settings I rarely touch. They're a little advanced, but they can be useful to create what's called bokeh in photography. Bokeh is essentially the quality of the blur, and it also refers to the blurry effect you see in background lights. Lowering the ratio will cause a horizontal distortion of the blur, and raising it above 1 will give it a vertical distortion. The blades simulate the number of blades on a real camera aperture. More blades gives a smoother blur, and the rotation setting I can barely see any effect from after playing around with it. For still renders, that's practically all you need to know about depth of field or background blur in Blender. But for animations, here are a few more tricks. First of all, these settings, like the f-stop, can be animated. So we could have the camera start off either in or out of focus and then transition. Just set the keyframes on the values for when we want the transitions to start and end. I'll link to a video on keyframe animation in Blender if you need some help with how all of that works. The second cool thing we could do is transition the focus point of the depth of field from one object or character to another. The best way to do this is with an empty. Shift A to add an empty object into the scene and place it where we want the camera's focus to begin. Let's make the empty the focus object in the camera's depth of field settings. Place a keyframe on the empty's location at the frame where we want the transition to begin. Then go to the frame in the animation when we want the transition to end. Move the empty to the new area of focus and then place a new keyframe on the empty's location. This will cause a smooth transition of focus from the first location of the empty to the second. Very cool effect that is used all the time in movies and TV. And by the way, these realistic characters were created very easily with Human Generator, which is probably my second favorite Blender add-on after Scatter. Links to both are in the description. Give the video a like and consider subscribing. Thank you and stay creative.